awesome. Mortal Kombat, you guys, I had a good time in this movie. I can't wait to talk about it. But before we dive in, hook your boy up with that HBO special. Y'all know what that is? That's the Help a Brother Out special. Hit that subscribe button, ding that bell, and hit like on this video for videos on the latest movies, TV shows, with a little sprinkle of anime and gaming, y'all. I'm here to review Mortal Kombat today, which follows Cole Young, an MMA fighter, and the world's greatest fighters as they band together to take on threats from the outer world in a battle to save the universe, y'all. I really enjoyed this movie with a cool cast in Joe Taslim as Sub-Zero, Hiroyuki Sanada as Scorpion, Louis Tan as Cole Young, Jessica McName as Sonya, Ludi Lin as Liu Kang, and Mashad Brooks as Jax. Now, guys, I am a Mortal Kombat gamer to the core. I love the first three games. I played the fourth game. There's a Shaolin Monks one. I really enjoyed that. Guys, I really like the Mortal Kombat franchise. I played X. I like the games a lot. This movie does a great job with the visuals. So let's start with what works, and I'm starting with that, the visual effects and the combat in Mortal freaking Kombat, guys. The battles were awesome. They were gory. They were over the top, just like the video games. These are the visuals that belonged in Paul W.S. Anderson's 1995 movie, which... ooh, the visuals in that we won't even talk about, but these visuals are absolutely incredible. I loved what they did with combo moves, with special moves, with fatalities, and with Sub-Zero's ice. Seriously, the visuals and the combat in this are absolutely amazing, guys. Flawless victory with that one, guys. They did a great job in the movie. So I love the combat, guys. I just loved even the hand-to-hand, Kung Lao taking his hat off and the blade on his hat. Like, so good. Raiden's lightning. The visuals are really well done in this. I mean, seriously. So that's my first really good thing that works, is the visuals. Another thing, the lore. I like that they include so many characters from Mortal Kombat, especially Scorpion and Sub-Zero. The two of them are the best part of the story, guys. I really enjoyed Scorpion and Sub-Zero's rivalry, the vengeful Scorpion persona, and how he was coming back to get his vengeance against Sub-Zero. Really like that. And this is behind Sub-Zero from the first game, so we will get Noob Saibot later on down the line for my Mortal Kombat fans. And for my Mortal Kombat casuals, guys, let's just say this is the last we're gonna see of him. And the other characters included, I mean, there's so many. Liu Kang, Sonya, Jax, Raiden. There are so many characters. Just about any popular character in the franchise pops up in this movie. Melina's in it, except for Johnny Cage, which later on down the line, I'm sure he will be involved, guys. But I thoroughly enjoyed the visuals, the lore, some of the characters. Now, let's get into what doesn't quite work as much. And I want to start off with the story. I think the story is pretty decent. The problem I have with the story is that it doesn't quite go exactly how I thought it would. I thought there would be a little bit more involvement with the tournament, and I don't want to say too much there because I don't want to spoil, but I was a little disappointed that it didn't involve the tournament as much as I thought it would. So that's probably my biggest gripe about the story. Another thing, I don't think it really explains the lore as well as it could for Mortal Kombat casual fans. I don't think it really dives too deep into the rivalry between Scorpion and Sub-Zero, why they are rivals. I don't think it really dives too deep on the actual tournament itself and the lore surrounding that, but it does do a good job of really introducing the abilities that the different characters have and why they do. So I think that that's a really good plot layer hidden underneath the so-so story, in my opinion. Also, some of the characters, just like I was saying earlier, I really liked that they included so many from the games. Some of the characters I wasn't too big on. Now, Shang Tsung, I really liked him, but I was not super huge on Cole Young, who is the main character. As a Mortal Kombat fan, I think maybe they should have just made Liu Kang the main character. I mean, look, he's like the Ryu of the Mortal Kombat franchise. You might as well make him the main character, and I think I had a little bit of an irk with that. I would have liked him to be the main and not Cole Young. I wasn't too big on Cole. I think he was just kind of a bit of a plain main character, so I was not really into him that much. I wish I would have liked Cole Young a lot more, but since he's gonna probably be the main character of this franchise, I hope he becomes more enjoyable as it goes down the line. Also, wasn't big on Kano. I thought Kano was trying a little too hard to be funny. There are some fun parts and some funny parts, but I thought maybe trying a little hard. But I did like most of the characters. They even included Melina, which was awesome with her crazy jaw and the crazy monster mouth she has. Goro looked absolutely amazing. Like, whew. Y'all, the visuals are stunning in this. Stunning, 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 guys. But all in all, I had a really good time watching Mortal Kombat. I just wish that I thought it was absolutely great. But look, I'm looking forward to sequels. I'm looking forward to threequels. I'm looking forward to the rest of this series, guys. For Mortal Kombat, I'm going a 7 out of 10, y'all. I just wish I could give it an 8 or a 9. But unfortunately, I didn't really like the main character. And I thought the story was a little weak. So it came up a bit short for me. But guys, let me know your thoughts down in the comments. What did you think about Mortal Kombat? If you've seen it, and if you're planning on seeing it, let me know. Who is your favorite Mortal Kombat character? Let me know down in the comments, guys. And y'all, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button for your boy Leo Rydell, and we'll see you next time on Geekly Goods.